Hey, how y'all doing out there today? Listen, it's the day before the insanity. It almost reminds me of Black Friday after Thanksgiving and how the Walmarts get. But everybody's feeling pressure this season to go vote, man. Vote Republican to stop Nancy Pelosi and vote Democrat to stop Trump. And I keep getting asked a bunch, and y'all know how I feel about it. And I've come to a good comfortable line of thinking that, hey, we can all be right or wrong about anything. So if I'm wrong about voting and it does work, a lot of people say, have asked me that, you know, like, Bill, you can't even, what if that, you're the ultimate truth. And no, I'm not. I based the federal level voting on some real quotes by some real presidents and some in a real new world order. You got to question some things. So if the vote did work, and I was asked by several people, so I'll answer all at one time, who would I vote for or whatever on this? Well, let's just look at how what I call the DC puppet show lie is built up. You got the Republican Party that's really supposed to represent people that probably make over $200,000 a year household income for sure. But individual, yeah, and above. And it's the corporate party. It's industry, dig it up, burn it up. Don't worry about that right there. We'll fix it tomorrow because we promised you. and the Democrats, I guess they're supposed to, they jumped on the environmentalist bandwagon since we turned into a minority, but they're the party supposed to be of the minorities and the people, when really they're supposed to be the workers' party. If you work and you make less than $250,000 a year, I don't know why you'd want to be a Republican. They kind of ain't looking out after you. Maybe your job or something. You know, I understand that. A lot of people think their jobs and their parties. But really what they got it down to is two things. They got it down to two things about fear. They got it down to gun control, and they got it down to people's rights. And when I say people's rights, they use abortion for one, or gay marriage, another one. These things would be divisive in anybody's society. With any group of people, and the people that are that way or feel that way, their strife feels strong. They feel oppressed. They feel like they don't get a fair shake because they're the minority, and the government makes them feel like the minority. But this would be the Democratic Party as well, because it is a party of the people. So that's what the two parties represent. One represents basically richer people, the master level people, and the other side represents we the people, the workers. And so looking at that, just look at the last couple years, y'all. If we're gonna get more of the same, then we're gonna get more deregulation, more creeks like this and farmland like that, woods like this. Everybody that's got something they love or whatever. This is my side of it. Now I'm just telling you, said who would I vote for? Well, I don't know about no individuals out there per se, cause I don't know all the characters in wrestling either, but I don't know all the football players on the team. So, but I do know, that the Republican Party stands for deregulation. They have lied to people and made it sound like it's, something good for the people when it was actually set up, you dumbasses, to protect people. So you had clean water when the other countries leave, when the out-of-state workers leave, you had some clean water like that. You got that, then I don't want to hear what you got, because you got nothing but paper money, and you got to go buy it. That's what your party stands for. That's what it's turned into, selling the Marcellus Shell to the Chinese, and it's under the Appalachian Mountains. Wow, that was pretty fucking clever. How can you sell something that's a mile to 3 miles deep under a mountain? How can you sell it to a foreign country and then say, well, hey, I'll drill on this. I'll buy this guy's land, or I'll buy this guy's land, and I can drill 3 or 4 miles in that direction and get all the coal seam gas I want, and poison air water and the radiation that it's leaking. All your fracking lies have come out, Republican Party. As far as the Democratic Party, and I don't think I'm jumping on no bandwagons. I told you I don't believe this lie, but y'all wanted to play fantasy voting. Well, here's your strengths and weaknesses of the Democratic Party. if you quit kissing the establishment's ass, if you quit kissing big oil's ass and actually do something instead of being controlled opposition and telling everybody to sit down and give peace a chance. Now you get out there and you really stand up for people. You talk about small communities. You start working your leadership towards people self-leading and not needing them as nothing but elders and guides. You tell the working man it's okay to be who you are and don't listen to the rest of the people out there because you're the real part of America. The diverse part, the different, the America. Fucking America. Everybody wasn't meant to live out here in these woods and everybody wasn't meant to live in them cities and everybody wasn't meant to live in a small town. Everybody wasn't meant to do nothing but be a fucking American. So why don't you get out there, Democratic Party, and say, hey, I want to work with you. Not about who grabbed whose coochie, not about who wants to be with her daughter, not about what one man that ain't even running for office in your fucking state or even in your region cares about. What do you care about? Care about them people? You got your rights to do anything that you want to. Now you just want to gripe about how nobody wants to accept them. Well, you getting rights, and this is everybody that's liberal or in the Democratic Party or consider yourself a minority or think that you need rights to be you. Well, when you get your rights and you still bitch about it, that don't make a whole bunch of sense to me. That means you get to go live it legally like you wanted. It don't mean that the masses of America or the world are going to accept your cause or care about your plight. That's where you find tribe and brothers, sisters that care, that understand, that say, yes, I understand, man, it sucks. But here we are now. We're in this boat and they're trying to call it the Democratic Party. But man, they're all too busy arguing with each other about how to sit down and get pepper sprayed at a fucking protest. Well, back in the day, if you got pepper sprayed, the cop got his ass whooped, and that's why they didn't pepper spray us. But no, they couldn't stop the man. They could only kill the man. They couldn't kill the idea. And the idea of peaceful protesting was never peaceful. It wasn't even that way back in the 60s, and you can all look that up. That's why they made marijuana and LSD a felony. That's why Nixon made all that a felony. They wanted to keep down their leadership, and they pretty much all just, mess with that and everything. So if you vote Democratic, you're voting for some people that are basically now controlled opposition. And once they get into office or they've been there forever, like Nancy Pelosi and like Dianne Feinstein and all these other establishment zombies out there, they'll get in there and they may, it may even be the raw new person, the fresh young leader that you think is there. Once they get there, they'll threaten them or buy them out, y'all. Big Oil's got more money than y'all think, and they can buy a president of the United States, the leader of the free world, because the free world don't need a leader. You bought that from day one, from day fucking one. And that's my problem with you, brothers and sisters, is that y'all bought into this big time when we the people all along were the power. So you're asking me who I vote for? I vote for you. That's who I vote for. I vote for you to change your community. I vote for you to be the new sheriff of your town. I vote for you to be the mayor of your town. I vote for you to do anything that you need to do to make sure that you're leaving clean water and clean food and everything to your children. That's who I vote for. But as far as this playing fantasy voting, I don't know. That's for y'all to decide, but I just say that the way it's